Yo, what it is, everybody. Thanks for tuning in for another episode here on the Speedbug channel. Y'all been asking a lot of updates on the Camaro and the ZL1. What's going on with this joker? Did we make the power that we wanted to? And you know, supporting mods and stuff like that. Yes. I'm just dump right into it. Yes, we absolutely did. This is my 2019 ZL1. It has a Magnuson blower and, of course, all the other goodies to go along with it. It is on 93 only, and the goal was to make 1,000 horsepower on 93. No meth, no E, nothing. Now, before you all run out and stuff like that and go to your tuners that make 600 and 700 and they say, oh, you couldn't do it, you know what? They're right. I tuned my own car. Now, I will offer 700 or 720, and hell, even 750, that's kind of pushing it. And it depends on really also, you know, what your torque numbers are, because torque is that cylinder pressure. And you obviously are going to advance timing because cylinder pressure is dropping past a certain RPM, and then you could really jack it up. But you still have to pay attention where your peak torque is and where your peak timing is for that peak torque. But you could just still only go so far with 93 octane. And then, of course, you know, I wanted to make a 9 second, you know, this is like my daily street car that I like to play with, as opposed not, you know, with my truck that I drive pretty much primarily every day. But I wanted to also be able to get into the nines on a 93 octane only tune. It's very easy to do on E85 and meth and stuff like that, or MS-109, C16, whatever you want to run. But I wanted to do it on 93, and I was able to do it. It was cool, and that's it. I don't run this car on kill all the time. It's not worth it. It's not worth putting a hole in a piston. It's not worth detonating. It's not worth, you know, having your SOI jacked up all the way, and hopefully that all the fuel gets into the cylinder and the AFR is absolutely correct. It's just not worth it. But there are plenty of other modifications that you do have to do to keep this and have it run the correct way. You know, your airflow ratio is key, especially in a direct injection car. And then, of course, all the other supporting mods that I did to go along with it. Now, when you look at it, it looks like a stock vehicle. It is not a stock vehicle. It's, you know, got, you know, full suspension, you know, control arms, carbon fiber drive shaft, carbon fiber axles, and stuff like that, all to make this do this on 93 octane. Remember, the only thing that you have cooling your piston on a direct injection car is the injection itself. That's it. It's not like a multi-port car, or if you're spraying meth, where you get away with it and have a shitload of octane from the methanol or anything else, or, you know, or cooling the valve or the back of the valve on the intake port with multi-port injection. Again, I'm not going to try and go too far into the tuning aspect, but for the ones that want to try and can get really close, you can, but just be afraid that you are pushing it. Was I able to do it? Yes, this car is now done and complete. I have no intention on doing anything else with it. Let me go open the hood for you guys. 93 only, and I have no intention to go any further than that. The reason why is because I already know myself. And if I want to go further, whether I put meth on it, or put E in it, convert it to full E, you know, everything else, I'm going to destroy this car. Kind of like how I did my Vette. And my Vette is my race car, and that's the way I'm going to keep it. I'm not going to change anything else on it. If I need to go fast, I'm going to jump in that car. That car makes damn near double this horsepower. So why destroy this car when this I can get this to drive perfectly fine? It just doesn't make a lot of sense now, does it? So I was able to do it, and I can run around with it, you know, running a mid-10 and be hot Florida heat, 100 degree, 130, 40 IAT temperatures, and I don't have to worry about this thing knocking, pre-ignition, nothing. It's a wonderful feeling. So for the ones that were wondering about this update and stuff like that, this car is now done and complete, and it was pretty cool that it can be done. The LT and the direct injection, you know, a lot of people don't like it. I actually personally love it. Even regardless of its limitations, I think it's pretty badass. Yes, after so much, you still need port injection and stuff like that, but it's still pretty damn cool what you can do and how precise you can get this over a multi-port injection car. And I just think it's pretty badass. And I just wanted to show you guys the update with this and let you guys know everything on this. And we are all pretty good at this, and we're pretty much done with the ZL1. And you'll see this more maybe playing around or doing some street races or hell, even at the racetrack where it belongs. So that's pretty much it. Thanks for tuning in for another episode here on the Speedbug channel, and we'll see you soon. Peace.